Okay, two very interesting presentations, and I'm sure we'll have a very lively discussion at the end. Let's have our third presentation, which I know will also be interesting, titled E-Learning Quality Assurance and Accreditation in Taiwan by Associate Professor Tony Kuo, and he is in the Department of Information and Management at National Open University of Taiwan.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. My topic is not that interesting like the professor. Oh, it's a little bit serious, but very important, right?
Yeah.
It's the e-learning quality assurance and the accreditation in Taiwan. E-learning has become extremely popular. So every teacher, I want to do an e-learning course. Because there are a lot of advantage of e-learning, such as convenient. How convenient? Oh, I can use the iPad or mobile device to access my course. So it's very convenient. Flexibility, I can learn anytime, anywhere. Oh, that's so great. And it also provides adaptive learning. You know what is adaptive learning? If I am very smart, and then I can learn the lesson very quickly. So the system will adjust the course content to fit my level. And the scalability. In the traditional classroom, you may have 50 students in the classroom, but if you put your course on the e-learning platform, and then you can let a lot of students, thousands of students learning together, so the scale can be very large. Okay, then what is e-learning? If you want to perform e-learning course, you may produce some e-learning digital material like this. In Taiwan, some university, the teacher have to produce such kind of media by themselves. So because I'm IT major teacher, so I can do it without program. But is there any teacher? Most of you are teacher, but is there non-IT background teacher? If I want to produce your digital material by yourself, how can you do that? Use your notebook and lay the webcam and record your voice and your picture. But the quality may be not good, right? And also we have the LMS, the platform, such kind of platform provide a discussion forum, a function for the homework submission. And also we may have a virtual classroom. So a student can virtually face-to-face meeting with the teacher. Also we have a cloud service for software learning. How to? For example, if you want to learn Photoshop, you know it's one kind of Adobe product for the image processing, but such kind of software is very expensive. So the student may not have money to buy it. So we provide the cloud service so student can access our cloud software from home to use it. So e-learning have to provide a lot of support to the teacher or to the student. And is e-learning always good for students? If you ask your student, maybe they will tell you some bad experience on the e-learning. For example, just as I said, maybe low quality media. Once I meet the teacher and he just showed me the media he record, and then I listen, oh, that a lot of noise from the microphone. So such kind of media is not good. And then boring content or bad instruction or deny. Certain teacher know how to do instruction or deny. Because in the physical classroom, we just prepare a PowerPoint slide and then we can introduce the content to the student without difficulty. But if you put your content on the e-learning platform, you have to deny some mechanism to let your student have the motivation to watch it. And so if you just a talking head on the video, then your student will fall asleep very quickly. And then the bad user interface of e-learning platform. As we know, an e-learning platform may have a lot of function. Then, you have to submit your homework next week. Okay, then I do the homework. And then how to submit it to the platform? Oh, you don't know how to get a way to do it. So there are a lot of bad experience the student told me. Huh? And another one, a feel lonely in learning. Because you access the e-learning platform, you stay at home and sit down the chair and watch the computer. Only you. And yeah. But if you in a traditional classroom, if you have any problem, you can raise your hand and ask the teacher or talk to your classmate. So e-learning is not that easy. So a lot of teachers just do e-learning, but don't know how to do good e-learning. So what is a good e-learning course? First of all, let's think about how to evaluate the quality of a traditional course. Anybody can tell me how to evaluate your course quality? At the end of the semester, all your students pass. Is that? Okay. Estimate your student achievement is the way. And then maybe we can have a questionnaire to the student. You are a good teacher. You teach very well. How to evaluate the quality of an e-learning course? That's the point that we want to discuss. So we need an e-learning quality assurance mechanism. So in Taiwan from 2006, the Taiwanese government launched a project to perform the e-learning quality assurance. We have an e-learning accreditation center, and in this center, a clear standard and the certification process are defined and to be performed. And this mechanism was recognized by the majority of universities as well as the community in Taiwan so far. And the item of the accreditation contain e-learning course or e-learning material and the master program by e-learning. In Taiwan, each school, the total student is limited due to the campus resource or the faculty number. But the government encouraged the university to perform the master program by e-learning. So if you pass the application, then you can recruit more students actually. So let's introduce the e-learning course accreditation. First, let's talk about how to expressment of the e-learning accreditation standard. Before 2006, a pilot project was launched. We invite about 5 professors and experts to form a small group and this group collect a lot of relevant literature or the foreign accreditation standard, and then we analyze the indicator and screen it. Finally, a set of prototype indicator was proposed. Then this proposal was delivered to another 20 experts to use the Delphi mechanism to discuss and do some revision. And then classify the similar indicator into the nine dimension. Finally, the accreditation specification and the standard was defined. And the indicator of the course accreditation are as follows. There are eight dimensions. The first dimension is course description. There are three required indicator and two option indicator. What is the required indicator? It means that you have to meet the specification criteria. You have to meet. And the option indicator means encourage you to meet the criteria. And the course description means in the e-learning course, you have to provide some information about what is the goal of this course. How many credits this course is the basic information for the course. And the second dimension is learning motivation keeping. You know, in the e-learning platform, maybe students feel very lonely or very, very boring. You have to do some instructional design, design some activity that the student to perform to motivate their study. And from dimension 3 to 5 is about interaction. So you know interaction is very important. What kind of interaction is needed in the e-learning course? Interaction of learner and the material. You know how to interact with learner and the material. Material, for example, video, how can I interact with video? Anybody know? I can put some in video quiz, you know? Because
in video quiz.
Yes. Some students know the teacher will monitor their learning status on the e-learning platform. So the e-learning platform will log everything you do. So if you play the video, the teacher will say, oh, you study very hard. But somebody, play it, then I go out to play the badminton or other things. So if you have the in-video quiz, the video will play and then stop when the quiz is. So you have to answer the question and then you will continue. And if you answer the question wrong, it means that you didn't realize the content the video just introduced. So you have to repeat again. So it's an interaction mechanism between a learner and the material. Okay, then what is the interaction of learner and the teacher? It means that we encourage students ask questions on the e-learning platform. You know Chinese culture. Student in the classroom. Oh, if you have any question, any problem? No, because students are very passive. Even in traditional classroom. So in the e-learning platform, students may be afraid of asking the question. So encourage the student ask question. And also, we want the teacher when the student posts a question on the discussion forum, then you have to reply or respond to the question in time and provide well feedback. The best way is in 2 days. And I will show the criteria for this indicator later. Okay, then the dimension 5 is interaction between learner. Because we say e-learning learners are always lonely because they didn't sit on the physical classroom, so they can talk to their classmates immediately. But actually, the e-learning platform provides synchronous and asynchronous mechanism to interact with your learner. For example, when I pose a question, of course, the teacher have to answer the question. But we also encourage other students or their classmates to respond this question too. So you may give some point to the student who asks more questions or respond more questions. And the dimension 6, evaluation. You know, in the e-learning platform, if you want to estimate the student's achievement, we want to know if the student know all the things I teach him. I give it a test or quiz, but most of quiz are happen in the physical place because of when you use the online test, it just can be a practice, but cannot be the measure of the achievement because they may open book or ask other beside. So the dimension 6, the evaluation mean we have provide a lot of online quiz or online test for the student, and after they do the test, we have to give the response to him immediately, so they can know how they wrong or others. And the dimension 7, service of instructional management. As I said, if you're a teacher or want to produce the video, he may need help. So the organization have provide, for example, a video studio or some technical person to help him to produce the video. And the dimension 6, the platform. In Taiwan, we have about 3 common platforms. Such kind of platform provide a lot of function, and then we will evaluate the function. For example, I have to provide forum, a discussion forum, provide function to submit a homework, or provide the monitor mechanism to watch the student behavior on the system, and so on. So totally, 37 indicators for the course accreditation. So how to pass the accreditation? The grade system. Each indicator includes 3 labels, A plus or A or B. A means meet the specification criteria, and A plus means better than the criteria, and B means fail the criteria. Yeah, fail. The achievement of accreditation required indicators should be at least grade A. And each dimension indicator should be at this grade A in average. That means if you got a B of option indicator, then you need an A plus to balance it. But if you have a required indicator B, then you fail because the required indicator must at least A. Okay? This is an example of the indicator. It's domain 4. The specification is instructor can respond well to learner's question in the discussion forum in time. A plus means within 2 days, and A within a week, and B more than a week or not respond. Okay, so such kind of criteria not just a quantity, but also quality. So the quality is the keyword well, but how to define well? So we need the expert to be our reviewer, the committee. Okay, this is an example. A question was proposed post on the discussion forum, and then we can check the day the question was posed. And the follow is the a teacher's response, 7 days, 7 days, just in time. So the reviewer will get into the platform and check it. But actually, it is hard to check everything on the platform, so they randomly choose to check. So the process is objective and rigorous assessment for the accreditation process. We have 4 examining committees, 2 e-learning specialists, and 2 field experts. You know, if you have a mathematical course applied for the accreditation, then we will invite 2 mathematical field experts. And the assessment process is we provide 2 to 3 weeks for the committee member to complete the assessment. After that, each committee member have a review result, but we need a consensus meeting to make all the committee's idea is consistent. For example, for the 4-4 indicator, one of the committee members say, oh, it's fail, B. And the other one say, oh, it's A. But why? Because they check the platform, someone check there is a post, exceed the response time, and the other one may not check it. Okay. So then, this table is the statistical result of the e-learning course accreditation since 2006 to last year. So almost approach 1,000 course was applied for the accreditation. And in average, the pass rate is about 51%. Not very high, but also not very, very low. And so far, we found the accreditation standard is not just a standard, but also provide a good guideline to help the teacher conducting a high quality e-learning course. So if the teacher want to perform the e-learning course, they may not know how to do, but he want to do, so he can check the indicator one by one, and then you know, I have to answer the question on the forum, or I have to do something, blah, 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 blah. So it's very valuable for this accreditation mechanism. And so far, we analyze the data from 2006 to last year. We find top 5 fail indicator is the domain, dimension 4, positive asynchronous interaction between indicator instructor and the learner. It means that most teachers don't know how to interact with their student in the e-learning platform. And dimension by passive synchronous interaction among learner. Asynchronous means when I have a virtual face-to-face meeting in the virtual classroom. Most condition is the teacher present the PowerPoint slide and deny some activity for the student to interact. And the third is passive synchronous interaction between instructor and the learner. For the dimension 5.3, it means that among learners, so cooperative activity have to be denied. For example, divide the student into some small group, and then they can work together for a small project. This is for the interaction among learner. And then online assistance service is provided. Because some university did not pay more budget for the e-learning course, so they have no money to provide enough assistance. And the instructor can respond well to learner's question in the discussion in time. Yeah. And this is our website. We provide a lot of things. For example, the full version of the all indicator. But so far, on the website, there are no English version. But we have. We may put it on the website quickly. Okay. This is my introduction. Any question? Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for all three presentations. So now we have some time for some questions. Do we have any questions from the audience? Can be on any one of the three presentations or any combination. Any questions?
Hi.
Hello.
Okay. My question is for Mr. How do you pronounce your name?
Tulun.
Okay. So you mentioned earlier that you're doing video vlogs for teaching, right?
Yes.
So do you have any advice or suggestions for those teachers who wanted to start or do video blogging on YouTube?
Video blogging on YouTube?
Yeah, the one that you're doing, how to start for beginners.
Okay. So should I reply now?
Sure.
Okay. In my own opinion, I think for YouTube, that is the most important thing is funny. So for beginner, actually, I've seen a lot of YouTube channel to teach Mandarin Chinese, and most of them I will only watch for not more than 3 minutes because they are doing like the normal class. So for my own opinion, for the beginner, you have to make it fun and make it short. So maybe only one sentence or one grammar point or three vocabularies in a time. That is my own opinion. But I'm not a YouTube expert, actually. So that is just my advice. You're welcome. Thank you.
Okay, we have some other questions. Anyone have questions for any one of the three presentations?
You are acting like Chinese culture. That is what Professor Tony said.
thank you for the presentation. I'm very curious why your university is collaborate with the Thai MOOC. What is the reason? This is a good news, but how can we do more collaboration kind of that? Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's really our honor to have this opportunity to deliver our MOOCs on Thai MOOCs. And thank you very much for the Cyber University project. And because the Ministry of Education in Taiwan encourage us to promote our MOOCs to Southeast Asia region. So some university choose Malaysia, some university choose Vietnam, and I like Thailand very much, so I choose Thailand as the first try. Thank you. People here is very nice, and the food is very delicious. And so I have this opportunity, and this project gave me can produce this course and delivery on Thai MOOCs. And we have another colleagues in Fengjia University that will visit Thai MOOCs team next month, because they provide the other MOOCs platform, and which is the Open EDU that was modified from Open EdX. And Taimo is MOOC platform is also modified from the Open EDU. MIT and Google released the platform, so different country, different university can use the platform to modify and customize for their own population. So they have the same platform, so we can have more collaboration, no matter in platform or course exchange. And so there will be another team to visit Cyber University next month, and looking for a further cooperation. And this is the first step we deliver our course on Taimo, and welcome students to enroll this course, and we'll provide an online instructor. He will answer questions in Thai. And thank you so much.
It's a wonderful opportunity. Do we have some other questions? We have time if anyone has any questions. Yes.
Thank you again for your presentation. I would like to ask about the four major MOOC platforms that you have in Taiwan. Yes. Are those, do you have any certain, like policy if someone want to create a course in the platforms? And you were saying that your platform is used by 62 universities just
yes,
now?
Yes.
So do they have to make some, like join for people to join or pay to certify certain payment or certain charges that you
Okay. Thanks for ask this question. There are four major platforms in Taiwan that was developed by university. They don't have a subsidy from Ministry of Education. So for example, E1 and Taiwan Life were sister platform. We provide service and allow university and institute to deliver their MOOCs on our platform. We will take no course, it's no cost. You have to pay on the platform. We have staff to service this university, but we don't take any fee from that. But there is only one platform now, they take a little charge, that is a share course. Provided by the Tsinghua University. Yes, share course will take a charge from university. But we don't take charge from university. We just provide free service. And Taiwan Life and E1 was modified from Moodle platform. Yes, OpenEDU was modified from the Open EdX. And share course was made by themselves. So they, yes, if the student you want to get a certificate, they have to pay some money to the share course. Yes, so far, it is the only one will take the take some money from student. It's the only one platform. The other three, it's totally free for learner and for the university. Yes, yes, yes. It's an online certificate, so it takes no money. It's very cheap. Yes, but the Ministry of Education do provide subsidy to producing more course. In average, it will give about 25,000 US dollars for each MOOCs. Yes, if you will pass the submit your proposal, where I want to do MOOCs and good quality, and they will find expert to evaluate. If you pass, they will give you money to do the MOOCs course, about 25,000 US dollars for. Yes, because many universities have this money to buy facility. Yes, you know, to recording course, and to have professional staff to produce course for them. So it takes a lot of money. So, okay.
For Dr. Oh, please, yes. These online courses, have you got any program to link this with face-to-face learning? Like if I study this course in Thailand, through online, would I have an opportunity to go to Taiwan and sit for 3 weeks and so on to practice and immerse it?
So you mean for Chinese learning or
for Chinese learning
training?
Oh, CSL, for CSL.
Okay.
Thank you.
We are for now. This time I came to Thailand and we have trying to. Visiting a lot of different language school or the school or the university, and we want to. This is the online course only online, so you can read it, you can watch it every time, anytime actually. But we also planning to cooperate with the university in the local, or the language school in the local, so the local school can help us to arrange online time. So that time we can use our platform in National Open University, and that time we can have online course while face to face. Yeah, in a real time.
And add a little bit. I'm from the Sukhothai Thammathirat Open University. Is a open university, and then
yes.
We have produced a lot of MOOC, and especially we pilot on the Chinese learning. So once you choose, it let me record a lot of my team. They're teaching Chinese by the case-based study. So I think that it would be very honor for you to join any kind of collaboration.
Of course, it's our pleasure.
Thank you so much. Yeah. And then I also have the visiting fellow from AAOU. He is from India. He is very super active in kind of OER and MOOC. Dr. Pandey, would you like to share something, please?
Hello, everybody. I'm Dr. Jitendra Pandey, and I'm from India. I represent Uttarakhand Open University, which is a state open university. So we are also hosting a lot of Moodle courses on digital literacy and cybersecurity, which are hosted on our Moodle platform, e-learning platform, and which are available as OER. So I'm also looking forward for some collaborations. I mean, we can discuss it afterwards. I mean, we are looking for collaboration. We are, it is always about sharing and learning. So I'm looking for some opportunities for that. Thank you very much.
Okay, do we have any further questions for our presenters this afternoon?
Okay, I want to thank all three of our presenters for a wonderful afternoon of presentations. We learned a lot, and I think we had a lot of wonderful opportunities, too, to collaborate and learn from you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.